Hi guys, my name is David from Pay It Forward.
And I'm David from Pay It Forward.
And in this video, we're going to show you how to put your iPhone into DFU mode and then do a DFU restore.
Yeah, a DFU restore is the deepest type of restore that you can do with an iPhone. And it's sort of the last resort for any Apple tech when there's some software problem that they can't solve. And if you think it's a hardware problem with your iPhone, it's a good idea to DFU restore it first. Other people watching this video are probably trying to jailbreak their phones, which is totally fine, no judgment. Or maybe they just want to put a different version on, or anyway. We're going to cover everything for DFU restore, and let's get right to it, okay? Now, we do recommend that you back up your iPhone first.
Yep, and we'll have a video on how to back up your iPhone in the description of this video.
Right, so this is an iPhone 7. It's blank right now. There's nothing on it, but I have an iCloud backup that I'm going to put on it a little bit later. And then what you need to know about DFU restores is that the process is a little bit different for iPhone 6S and below and iPhone 7 and above. So on an iPhone 6S and below, we're talking about two buttons with the DFU restore. 6S and below, we're talking about the power button and the home button. With an iPhone 7 and above, we're going to be using the power button and the volume down button. That's just because with the iPhone 7, they created a new home button that isn't a physical button. So they needed something that they could actually click in case the phone is off. So let's get to it. iPhone 7 DFU restore. First thing you need to do is to plug in your iPhone to a computer. You can't put your iPhone into DFU mode unless it's plugged into iTunes. So plugging it in, plugging it into this Mac. Now I've never hooked up this iPhone and synced it with this iTunes library before, and that's totally okay. It's okay to use a friend's Mac to do this or anything else. We're just using the Mac right now as a tool to restore the iPhone.
Excellent.
So let's say you're having a problem with your computer. It's all good. So iTunes is now open on this Mac, and I'm gonna put this into DFU mode. The good thing about DFU mode is that you can basically put an iPhone into DFU mode and ignore everything else that's going on. So even if your iPhone is off or the screen's off, or maybe the screen's broken, you don't know if it's broken, sometimes you can put an iPhone into DFU mode even if it seems like it's completely dead. Definitely something worth trying before you go to the Apple Store for repair, because the tech will just do it there. So how do you put an iPhone into DFU mode? There's 8 seconds we have to worry about. If you're an Apple tech, what they tell you is, for the first 5 seconds, hold the power button and the volume down button together. And then let go of the power button and keep holding the volume down button. Similarly, iPhone 6S and below, for the first 5 seconds, hold the power button and the home button down together, and then let go of the power button and keep holding the home button. Anyway, it's easy when you see it.
Well, let's show them.
All right. So, power button, volume down button, iPhone 7. Hold them down together until the screen goes black, about 5 seconds, and then just let go of the power button and keep holding this volume down button until on your Mac, something shows up on the screen that says, iTunes has detected an iPhone in recovery mode. You must restore this iPhone before it can be used with iTunes. Success.
Awesome.
Now, if you see anything on your iPhone screen, if you see recovery mode or like a little connect to iTunes logo, you're not in DFU mode. So the only way you're in DFU mode is if you see this stuff in iTunes that says it detects an iPhone and your screen is completely black. There are no exceptions to this rule. So, okay, let's click OK. Now, all you can really do here is eject the phone, which we don't want to do, or restore the iPhone, which is exactly
That's what we want to do.
So there's a couple of things to be aware of here. The first one is if you just click this button normally, and this is probably what everybody's going to want to do, or most people, let's say they're having a problem with your iPhone, just click this button. What's going to happen is iTunes will ask you, are you sure you want to restore this phone to its factory settings? Everything will be erased. And then the newest version of the iPhone software will be installed. So what iTunes does is it goes to Apple servers and it downloads the most recent version of the iPhone operating system for you. It can take like 10, 20 minutes depending on your internet connection. And then it'll DFU restore your phone, another 10, 15 minutes depending on your phone. There's another option here. So most people should just click restore and update.
Yep.
Now, our case is a little bit different, and if you're jailbreaking your phone or doing something nefarious, or if you're like us and we're running a beta of iOS 11 at this point, we need to do it a little bit differently. So instead of having iTunes go ahead and download the restore file by itself from the Apple servers, we're going to choose a file that we already downloaded to restore from.
And we'll link to the website where you can download these iOS versions in the description.
Yep. And so the way to do that, and there's a little trick for Mac, a little trick for PC. On a Mac, you hold the Option key, and on a PC, you hold the Alt key. And while you're doing that, click on Restore iPhone. And instead of popping up with the iTunes little box that asks if you want to restore it their way, you're going to get this little pop-up and just choose the software. So I've downloaded this iPhone 7 beta of iOS 11, which I'm going to put on my iPhone. I'm just going to say open. Now iTunes is going to say, okay, here's what we're going to do. We're going to do it.
Yep.
Hit restore.
Restore.
Bang.
Bang. iPhone cannot be restored. Well, great. That is not what we thought would happen.
Well, yeah. So what happened right there? Something went wrong, clearly.
Oops.
So my iPhone kicked out of recovery mode, kicked out of DFU mode for whatever reason. Maybe we took too long. Maybe the computer, you know, whatever. Let's put it back into DFU mode. So even though it's not fully turned on yet, I can just do this. This is a good teachable moment.
Right.
Wait until the screen turns off. 3 seconds. One. Well, screen's got to be all the way off. I'm holding the home button. Let's put this into DFU mode. So if it was an iPhone 6S, that would have totally worked. Let's do an iPhone 7, right. Screen's off. 3 seconds. Two. One. Let go of the power button. Keep holding the volume down button. iPhone goes into DFU mode.
Nice.
All right, restore iPhone. I'm going to hold the Option key and click on that to select the file. I'm going to hit restore.
And now we play the waiting game.
We do indeed.
We'll fast forward to these loading bars.
Yeah.
So after iTunes does its thing for a little while and it starts the restore process, what you're going to see is the Apple logo appear on the screen with a little status bar or progress bar at the bottom that's going to very, very slowly work its way across the screen. Now, don't get your hopes up when this finishes because...
You got another status bar coming.
Yeah, another one right behind it, but it's a lot faster than the first status bar. Yep. So we're going to go back into our time warp.
Yep.
Because this is...
Yeah!
All right, so we're done with the first progress bar. Got the Apple logo on the screen.
Excellent.
You think it's going to turn back on and you're done, but you're not done. There's another progress
bar. Progress bar. Be patient.
Yep.
You're almost there.
Almost there.
25th mile of the marathon.
Oh, yeah. Welcome to your new iPhone, it says. So our DFU restore process is finished. Now, a lot of people ask, I want to restore from my iCloud backup, or I have activation lock turned on. Do I have to use my computer to do any of that stuff? And the answer is no. At the Apple Store, when people would have their phones DFU restored, one of our goals was to get people out the door as fast as possible. Mm-hmm. So in addition to providing great customer service at every turn, we did hand people their phones back. And pulled it right out of our computers that we use to restore iPhones.
Right.
So it's done, computer out of the way. And this is also especially helpful if you used your friend's computer to DFU restore your iPhone because your computer stinks.
Yeah.
This is helpful to do. So iTunes is just a tool here. It has nothing to do with the music library. We're just using it as a tool.
So the DFU restore is complete.
DFU done.
So he's going to set his iPhone up. I'm going to say thank you guys for watching this video. Yep. Feel free to leave us a comment down below if you have any other questions. We know the DFU process can be a bit complicated and errors do happen along the way. So feel free to leave anything in the comments.
Yeah, stick with it. You can get it into DFU mode. You can do it.
And make sure to visit payitforward.com for the best iPhone help online. And once again,
subscribe to this channel for the best content too.
Thank you guys for watching.